Good afternoon, students. How are you all? Hope you all are fine at your home and have safe. Okay, so let's start the chapter number one and continue it. So our subject is mathematics. Okay, and we continue the chapter number one today. And today we complete this chapter and start next chapter in the next lecture. Okay, today in this lecture we complete this chapter. Okay, so let's start. Okay, see this, at the last we had done this exercise, even and odd number. So you know what is even and odd number? As I said, see here, you can see the pairs of the balls, right? In number A you can see here. Okay, so if there are any balls are left alone, so that is not an even number. Okay, that is odd number. But here you can see in the number A there are one ball are left, so this number is not an even number. Okay, let's count it. See this, how many numbers are there? See, this is the one group, this is two group, this is three, and here is four. There are four groups of balls, but there are one is left. You can see this, that how many balls are there? You can see 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, and this one is left, so this is 9. So we write this 9 number as an odd number. Okay, see this chocolates, we also done this chocolates. How much chocolates are there? See this, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and 10. There are 10 chocolates. But let's check, there are two pairs are there. Can we make two pairs? Any chocolates are left? See this, I made the pairs of them. Yeah, this is the even number because there is no number, there is no chocolate left. Okay, so we'll write 10 number as an even number and put dash at the odd number. So this is the way you have to complete this exercise, students. See this number, see, can you count these flowers? Let's make pair first, one pair, two pair, and three pair. So you can see this one flower is left alone, so this is the odd number. So how much flower it is? 1 2 3 4 5 6 and 7. So number 7 will come with odd numbers. Okay, 7 will come with the odd numbers, and odd numbers, here is odd number. See this, so you have to write down 7 number in the odd place. Okay, now the apple is there. So first of all, count the how many apples are there. Let's make pair of it, one pair, two pair, and there are three pairs. So you can see there are no apple left. Okay, so this is the 6 apples. Let's count 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. So we'll write 6 in the evens place. Okay, let's write 6 at the evens place. Let's check where is the evens place are there. See this, even, here is even number. So let's write 6 in at the evens place. Okay, put dash at the odds place. Okay, so this is the way. See, this is the cupcake. So let's count it and make the pair 1 and 2. See, you can see this one cupcake is alone, so this number will go with the odd number. And how much cake it is? 1 2 3 4 and 5. So this is the 5 cakes will go with the odd numbers. Okay, so here are the odd numbers. See, and you have to put dash at the evens number place. Okay, so this is the way you have to done this exercise. And last one, number F. Let's make pair first of this socks. See, 1 2 3 and 4. There are 4 pairs, and 4 2s are 8. It means 4, it means 8 socks are there. So 8 will go with the even numbers. Okay, so this is the way you have to complete this exercise. This is your textbook exercise. You can see this, this is the exercise 1E. So this is the even and odd. Okay, let me tell you one trick of understood the even and odd number. Let's see. For the shortcut, if you have any doubt, then how to identify this number is odd or even. So there is one trick. If
See, this is you have to check ones place. Which place? You have to check ones place of every digit. See, this is the ones place. Okay, you have to check if there are digit 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. If this digit will come at the ones place, then this number will odd number. Which number? Odd number. If this number 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9, I repeat, 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9, if you see at the ones place this digits, this 5 digit to 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9 at the ones place, then that number will be a odd number. Understood? This is the shortcut trick to easily identify the number which is odd or even. Okay, so this is the way. Please remember this number for the odd number 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 at the ones place. Okay, at the ones place. Okay, so for the even number, what for the even number? Okay, for the even number, you have to check at the ones place 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0. 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. If you find these numbers at the ones place, 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0 at the ones place, so this number will be a even number. Please remember this. If you found 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, these 5 numbers at the ones place, so identify this number as a even number. Understood? This is very easy. So let's take example of it. Okay.
Let's take example. This is the worksheet of you, so please note down it in your book. Okay, let's solve it by the ones place. Okay, let's check the ones place here. Okay, see this, here is the number 16, so please check the ones place. See, as I said, check the ones value. If this is 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9, so it will be an odd number. And if there will be a 0, 2, 6, 8 and 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, so it will be an even number. So you can check here, this is the even number 16. See, here is the 7 number, so 7 is the odd number. Okay, see this number 23 at the ones place, there are 3, so this number is an odd number. Okay, this is an odd number. See, here is 5, so at the ones place there is a 5 number, so this is also an odd number. Please write down with me, students, this is your worksheet. Okay, see the next number 4. As I said, if there are 4 in the ones place, then this number will be a even number. Okay, see this next number 6. 6 is also an even number, so this number 6 is also an even number. See here number 5 at the ones place, so as I said, 5 is at the ones place, so it will be an odd number. So here 65 number is also a odd number. Here is 54, but there is ones place is a 4 number, so this number is a even number because 4 is at the ones place. Now number 87, so here is 7 is at the ones place, so this number is an odd number. Okay, now 13 number, so 3 is also odd number, so let's take 13 as an odd number. Next one, 22 number, so 2 is at the ones place, so let's take 22 as an even number. So even number 22. 17, 7 is odd number as you see above, so 17 is also an odd number. Okay, let's take 17 as an odd number. Next one is a 33, so 3 is a ones place and 3 is an odd number, so 33 is an odd number. Let's take it. Okay, write down odd. Now next is 44, so 4 is an even number and here is 44 number, so let's take this number as an even number. Okay, hope you understood this, students. This is very easy. Okay, you have to just check ones value and the numbers you have to remember. Okay, okay, let's take another example. See this. Okay, 54. 4 is a even number, so let's take 54 as a even. please note down this students. And 44, as we said, this is also an even number. Now here is a 0 at the ones place. As I said, if 0 is at the ones place, so please take this number as an even number. Okay. Now 2 is at the ones place. So 2 is also an even number. So let's take 72 as an even number. Now there is next number, 48. So 8 is at the ones place. So 8 is an even number. So let's take 48 number as an even number. Understood, students? Now here is 0. Again 0. So let's take this number as an even number, because there are 0 is at the ones place. Again here is 0 at the ones place. So let's take 3030 number as an even number. Okay. Here is 2. 2 is also an even number. So let's take 62 as an even number. This is also an even number. Here is 1, 51. There are 1 is at the ones place. So 1 is an odd number. So 51 is an odd number. Okay. Here is 19. 9 is also an odd number. Okay. So let's take 9 as an odd number. So number 19 is an odd one. Here is 79. As we seen, number 9 is an odd one. So 79 is also an odd number. Okay. Now here is 2. There is one digit number, but 2 number is an even number. So 2 is an even number. Okay. Now 0 again. So if you find 0 at the ones place, so this number is an even number. So 60 is an even number. Here is 99, but 9 is at the ones place we found. So 9 is an odd number. So 99 is an odd number. Hope there is no doubt in this worksheet. This is very easy. If you check ones number, then you will find the answer. Okay. I'll show you this worksheet again. So please note down this worksheet in your book. See, this is odd or even number worksheet. Okay, slowly I'll scroll this worksheet on the screen. So please note down, this is very easy number. Okay. This is your homework also. You have to write down this as a homework in your square line book. This is the exercise, and please use this as a worksheet. Okay. See this, I scroll it very slowly so you can write it fast in your book. Please write down these numbers in your book. You can use your own example also for more practice. Okay, students. See this, very easy. And we solved it also. So please. So let's take one more example of the odd and even number. So see, this is like one activity of your worksheet. See this, there are two columns. One is for odd and one is for even. So you have to also make, there are two columns in your book. One part is for the odd one and one part is for the even one. See, here are the numbers. Here are some numbers you have to write down at the correct box. Take the number and write it down at the correct place. So here is the number 16. Okay. First number is the 16 number. So see this, 6 is at the ones place. So 6 is an even number. So 16 goes for the even. Okay. 16 will go for the even number. Okay. See this, you can see very clearly with the number. Okay, now number 5. Let's write first 16 number at the evens place. Now there is number 5. So 5 is an odd number. Okay. Now 36. Again 6. So 36 is an even number. Now 29. So 9 is an odd number. So 29 will go with the odd number. Here is 88. So 88. 8 is the ones place. So 88 is an even number. Now here is 59. So 9 is an odd number. So let's write 59 as an odd number. See, here is the 17. 7 is at the ones place and 7 is an odd number. So let's write 17 is an odds box. 8, 48. So as we said, 8 is an even number. So write down 48 as an even number. Okay, next one, 77. So 7 is an odd number at the ones place. So write down 77 number in the odd place. See, here is 24 number. So 24, 4 is at the ones place. So 24 we take as an even number. Let's write 24 in the evens box.
Next is 72. So here 2 is at the ones place. So 2 is an even number. So let's write 72 at the even box. 97. So 7 is a odd number. So let's write 97 in the box of odd. Here is 54. So 54. So 4 is at the ones place. So 4 is a even number. So let's write 54 at the even. Here I have a space problem, so I have written this way. So please, you can write properly in your book. Here is 94. So 94 is also an even number because 4 is at the ones place. Next is 33. So 33 is a odd number because 3 is at the ones place and 3 is the odd number. And here is 68 number. So you must write 68 in the even number because 8 is at the ones place and 8 is a even number. So this will be easy. This is a very interesting game. Okay. So you have to note down this game in your book also. See, you have to just note down these numbers and this two box, and you have to do this by your own. Understood this? So this, it will be a very easy. Okay, I'll show you the number. Please note down this in your book. See this. This is the numbers. Please note down these numbers also, and then make two parts of one is for odd and one is for even. Okay, then you just do this activity. Okay, this is very easy. See, this way you have to make two boxes. One is for odd and one is for even. Then note down these numbers and write down in the correct box. Okay, so this is very easy for you. See here, you can see this. Here are some persons are standing in a line. So you have to decide the position of it. You can see the positions of there. There are some numbers are written on the stairs. You can see. See, here is the lady who is standing at the first stair. You can see here. See, this is the first one. So this is the position. This is the first one. Okay. Now, what it means, here is this man is at the second position. You can see here. See, he is the second position. This ordinal number shows the position of your situation. These numbers represent the position. See, this number are third one and this boy is the third position. Okay. See, here is the fourth one. This person is at the fourth number. Okay. See, this here is the fifth lady. See, this lady is standing on the fifth stair. It means this lady will go at the fifth number. Okay. Then here is the person. You can see here he is yellow in color clothes. So this person is at the sixth position. So his number is sixth one. Okay. Now see here, there are one boy again in the yellow or green t-shirt. So this is the position of this man is the seventh. Okay. After him, there is one lady in the purple clothes. So the position of this lady is eighth, right? You can see here. There is a stairs. There are number written is 8. After in the red clothes, you can see here. See this, the red cloth boy. He is at the ninth position. So it means he have to go after this 8 person. Then the nine number person will go. See here, there are the white shirt boy. His position is 10th. It means what it means, after that 9 person will visited the bank, then he will go to the visit. So this is the ordinal numbers. See this, you can very easily identify. See, here is the spelling, how to write the ordinal numbers. See, first, how to write first, not O-N-E-1, you have to write down first. See, this is the spelling of first, you can see here. Okay, this is the one. See, here is the second number. Okay, here is the third one, here is the fourth one, here is the fifth one. So this is the spelling of this ordinal numbers. You have to note down it. Okay, see this, here is the sixth, here is the sixth spelling, here is the eighth spelling, here is the ninth spelling, and here is the tenth one. See, there is only th. Whatever you add this here, you have to add in the spelling. Okay, see, here you have th in the number, you have to add here in the spelling also. See this, in the sixth there are th, so here also you can see this th here, right? So this is the way you have to
go with the ordinal number. Okay, you also use this ordinal number in your routine life. You know how you use this ordinal number in your routine life?
Okay, whenever the result declare of your exam, right? So you are waiting for your rank, which number, which rank you will got. So first rank, second rank, third rank, what it shows? It shows the position. You are at which position? First rank, it means you are at the first position. Second rank, it means you are at the second position. Third rank, it means you are at the third position. Understood this? Okay, then you also use this ordinal number as a standard. Okay, you are using this to recognize the standard. Some students are saying I am in first standard. They can't say I am in one standard. They use first because this is the ordinal number. In the second standard students, they are using second. I am in second students. They are using this language, this ordinal number, okay, to represent their class. Third standard, fourth standard, fifth standard, sixth standard, seventh, eighth, ninth and tenth, 11th, 12th. You are using this way to represent the standard, okay. So here is the picture. You can see this. Match the place of each child to the ordinal, okay. Here is the some numbers you can see here, okay. Now you have to match it with the numbers, okay, with the students. See here, I'll show you something. Here is the first students, so he is at the first position, so you have to match it with the position number one. So can you tell me where is the position number one? Okay, see this, you can see now very clearly. See, he is the first one, so you have to match it with the number one. See, repeat, this boy is at the first position, so you have to match it with the first number. Now this, the next boy is at the second position, okay, so you have to match it with the second number. See, here is the second number. After it, the girl is at the third position, so you have to match third number with this girl. So you can easily understood, you can see very easily. After this girl, number three, see, there are one girl who is at the fourth position, right? So you have to match this number with the fourth position. You can see very easily. After the fourth position, there are one boy who is at the fifth position, right? So please match this number at the fifth position. See, I match this, you can see. After that, there is one girl who is at the sixth position, okay. See, I match this with the sixth one. See, there are the one girl is at the seventh position, so I'll match it with the seventh number. Then there are the boy is at the eighth place. See, then the second last is the ninth position, and this boy is at the last position. So this way you have to match, okay, this way you have to match this. So this is the ordinal numbers, you can very easily recognize first, second, third, fourth, okay. Now here is some blanks, but this is the period wise, you don't have to write down it. This is the thing you have to see, students. You can see here, there is one worksheet for you. See, there is some animals are there, and see this, okay. Let's write something here, okay. You can see the first one is a lion, he is at the first position, right? The second one is a monkey, so this is at the second place. Elephant is at the third place. See, this is the giraffe is at the fourth place, and the last animal is at the fifth place, right? So you have to note down this. See, here is the monkey. See this, you can see here, okay. See this, I am talking about this thing, this blank number one, okay. The monkey is in the second spot. It means monkey is at the second spot. What for the second blank? The lion is in the, so what you should write there first. So this is the right answer of this. The lion is at the first spot. Then the last one, what is this? How, which place at this last animal? Let's see. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So here is the answer, fifth. You don't write
5 only. You have to write down this th above the 5, so it will be an ordinal number. Understood this? Now about the elephant. So elephant is at the third place. So how to write third? You have to write down 3 and you have to add this rd here, so it will be an ordinal number now. Okay, see the giraffe, which position at the giraffe is? Let's count again. 1, 2, 3 and 4th. Yes, giraffe is at the fourth position. So how to write fourth? You have to write down 4 and just add a th. It means fourth. So giraffe is at the fourth spot. Understood? See this. This is very easy thing. Ordinal number worksheet. Okay, I will send you this worksheet as a homework. But you easily understood. There are no doubt in it. Okay, understood students? This is very easy. Okay student, let's take one more example of it. See this. Here is the, you have to match the number with its spelling. Okay, 1 to 10th spelling with its ordinal spelling. You have to match with it. Okay, see here. Okay, there are only one example is done for you. Number second, you have to match it with the second. Now, the next one is number fourth. So, where is number fourth? Have you found? Yes, hope your answer is what I match. This is the fourth one. Now here is the number 5, fifth. So you have to match it with fifth. Let's find where is the fifth number. The spelling of fifth is at the first position, fifth. Now the third one. So let's take, please find where is number third. Please students also find. Yes, you are right. Students are right, third. Okay. Fifth is here and fourth is here. Okay, now 10th one. Find out where is the 10th one. Where is the spelling of 10th? Please find out students. Yes, here is the 10th one. Then where is the first? Where is the spelling of first? Yes, here is the spelling of first. Okay, please note down with me. You have to do this in your book also. This is your homework. 7th one. See, here is the spelling of 7th. S-E-V-E-N-T-H, 7th, okay? Okay, so this is the spelling of 7th. Now, there is number 9th. Where is the spelling of 9th? At the last, see this, N-I-N-T-H, 9th. Then, 8th. Where is the spelling of 8th? Can you find? Yes, here is the spelling, 8th. Then last one, 6th. Where is the number 6th? See this, this is the way you have to match the numbers, okay? So you have to do this in your book. I will send this worksheet in your WhatsApp group. So please note down this. Okay, so it is very easy students. There is nothing hard in this. So hope you understood this concept. First one is odd and even number, and here the last topic of this chapter is also a ordinal number, and hope you understood this. Okay. See this, this is the worksheet I will send you. Please note down this in your worksheet. Okay, let's see. Students, here after completing this chapter, after completing this topic, ordinal number, here we complete our chapter. Okay, this chapter is completed here. Okay, let's see which topics we complete in this chapter. See, first chapter, numbers up to 200, we completed here. Okay, in this we looking back for the first standard also. Exercise 1 we completed. Please note down this worksheet 1A in your book. I send it to you. This is the done. Number 100 to 200, this is also done. Here is the number after, before and between also done. This exercise also done. This topic, place value, we cleared, right? And also done the exercise of it. This is the new topic, expanded form, we also done this. Here is the blanks, we also done this. Here is the colored digit place value, we also done this. Counting in tens, we cleared this, we solved it. See this worksheet, this is the textbook exercise, we also clear, we solved it. Okay. Then the next topic was that comparing numbers, we also complete. Equal to, greater than and less than, see we also complete this, right? Then the exercise 1C, we also complete this exercise and also online solved it. So there is no doubt in it.
This is the very easiest thing, greatest number and smallest number, you have to ring that number. This is very also. Then the next topic was ordering of numbers. It was increasing and decreasing. We also done this exercise. In the previous lecture we solved this, and this is very easy. Okay, so last exercise was this even and odd numbers, right? So you have to done this exercise, you have to do this exercise in the square line book. Okay, see this ordinal numbers we also solved the worksheet of it. So this is very easy, students. So please note down this. Okay, so your today's homework is complete the full chapter in your fair book. Complete the full chapter, chapter 1 in the full in the your fair book. Okay, in the next lecture, okay, we will start chapter number 2, and I will send you the PDF of that chapter so you can easily understood what I am going to learn. Okay, so please hope you will enjoy this lecture, this chapter. There is no doubt in this chapter. So goodbye, students. We'll meet in the next lecture with the next chapter. Bye bye.